Leader's questions, I'd like to call on Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Kion Corlam.
2 minutes.
Tánaiste, to the former Minister for the Environment, John Gormley, as you know, established an independent review into the planning practices of a number of local authorities, and indeed had undertaken considerable work to ensure that those would happen. Well, I'll come to that now, Minister Rabbit. Well, I'd like to ask Tánaiste, why is Minister Phil Hogan, Minister Alan Kelly, Minister Keogh misleading the public when they have said that Minister Gormley had done nothing to progress his independent reviews of planning practices in a number of local authorities? And over a year since he took office, why don't we still have any outcome of his internal reviews 9 months after he suppressed the independent reviews that Minister Gormley had established? I would just like to put on the record of the House what Minister Hogan had on his desk when he arrived into office. He had an extensive dossier prepared by planning officials in the department following an internal review of the complaints, which went on from 07 to 09. He had a series of reports from the managers in each of the local authorities submitted in response to a formal request from the Minister using his statutory powers under the Planning and Development Acts. He had terms of reference for a panel of planning consultants to carry out independent reviews in the 6 local authorities. He had a completed tender process to select this panel of consultants, and he had letters of appointment ready to be issued to the members of that panel. And he was absolutely convinced, on the basis of the dossiers presented to him, that this required an independent review of planning. Now, with all of the debate that's going on this week in the House, everybody seems to be agreed that the planning process has to be above reproach. There are very significant reasons why Minister Gormley
question,
proceeded
please.
With these inquiries. And frankly, questions need to be answered as to why an independent review was suppressed by this incoming government. It's a very serious issue that demands a serious response from the government.
Thank you.
And I'm asking, why was the independent reviews established by Minister Gormley suppressed?
Excuse me. The Tánaiste is quite capable of answering the question without assistance.
Thank you,
please allow somebody to ask a question. I've worked with him long enough, and I have every confidence in him.
Thanks, Kyle Corlan.
Thank you.
I'm greatly reassured by your confidence. Can I welcome Deputy Martin's interest in probity in the planning system? The former Minister for the Environment, Heritage and Local Government, Minister Gormley, announced independent inquiries into 7 local authorities in June 2010. When he left office more than 7 months later, he had still not commenced these. The new minister considered that the very considerable cost of retaining consultants to conduct these inquiries required some further examination. He instructed officials to conduct an internal review and to report to him on what further actions might be warranted. These further actions might include changes to legislation, new regulations, or further guidance on a range of issues in the operation of the planning system in local authorities. However, the findings of the internal review were not to be prejudged, and it was always the case that some further investigations, including independent inquiries as originally announced, might form part of those outcomes. And that remains the position today. The review will be completed following the publication of the retail planning guidelines, which are due for publication before the end of April. The Minister has committed to issuing a public statement outlining in full the complaints that are at issue, the response, and any appropriate actions to be pursued in regard to further policy development and guidance in line with the commitments in the Programme for Government and the relevant recommendations in the report of the Mahon Tribunal report. So there is no planning inquiry being suppressed, Deputy Martin. The reviews are being conducted in the Department of the Environment. When that process is completed, as I said, following the publication of the retail planning guidelines at the end of April, there will be a full public statement made which will set out in full the complaints which were made, the action that was taken in the Department of the Environment to review those complaints and examine them, and then what further action might need to be taken arising from those reviews. So nothing is being suppressed. It's being looked at in the Department of the Environment, and the full information will be published.
Thank you. Deputy Martin, 1 minute.
I have to say that's completely disingenuous. Because it's very important to point out that an internal review of these complaints has already been carried out. That answer this morning is a complete whitewash. No, and the bottom line is, as far back as 2009, the spatial planning section of the Department of the Environment had already carried out an internal review of planning practices in these counties. And just to give you an illustration in terms of the former Louth County Manager, Mr. Quinlivan, who carried out an investigation into Carlow.
Sorry, this is and a he supplementary said he rendered, question, please.
I'm asking a question. It's a very serious issue.
I appreciate
and
that.
And he said...
But you have 1 minute.
He said it's important
seconds,
that he said that effective planning enforcement to ensure legislation observed in practice was not in place in Carlow. It rendered the whole enforcement process questionable, and Quinlivan recommended that, quote, prolonged consultation with those who breached the planning system must not take place. Complaints were received from many people,
Sorry,
from the public, from the Ombudsman, from Antashka, and many other reputable bodies about planning practices in these counties in recent years. And all of the heckling, and I'm not prejudging anything.
All your councillors.
I'm not prejudging
you please
anything.
Ask your question.
It's all your councillors controlling.
I'm not prejudging anything. I have no difficulty, without fear or favour, of having independent planning investigation. And why? Because I can tell you, I've spoken to Minister
Gordon. You're over time. Would you please
ask your question?
And the
bottom line here is there was internal resistance to these inquiries in the system. That's the bottom line here. Internal resistance to these planning investigations. And I asked questions last evening in the debate, are we all satisfied that our planning process is above reproach?
Thank you.
And I would simply say to you, I would ask you, Taoiseach, to go and meet Minister Gormley.
Thank you.
Go and look at the dossier yourself. Look at the extensive material. He established it. He established an independent inquiry. He established the process.
Thank you,
it
Deputy.
Was suppressed. And it is completely dishonest to say, it is completely dishonest to say that there's now another internal review. An internal review had been completed.
Thank you, Deputy.
Consultants
you
were appointed.
Seat?
And Minister Hogan, who had said prior to this that there were spurious complaints, he went off and suppressed them when
Deputy,
he came into office.
Please resume your seat. It's just about asking you a question. Thank you very much. Taoiseach. Taoiseach will reply. Thank you. Now, can I have some silence, please? Thank you.
Yeah,
we can't hear what's been said.
The position, Deputy Martin, is that each year the Department of the Environment receives about 8,000 representations from various sources, members of the public, NGOs, representative organisations, and sometimes planning authorities themselves. And some of these concern complaints and dissatisfaction with regard to planning decisions or planning policies that have been carried out. Now, specifically, there were a number of those that were identified by Minister Gormley in a number of local authorities. The local authorities concerned were Dublin City Council, Carlow County Council, Galway County Council, Cork City Council, Cork County Council, Meath County Council, and Donegal County Council. Those are being examined, and what is being I mean, first of all, there is no suppression here. No suppression. There was nothing in reality done about those in the period from the time that they were announced until Minister Gormley left office. There was some question of appointing consultants, but you know, you don't have to have consultants for everything. I mean, one of the problems of the last government was anytime, Deputy Martin, that there was an issue to be addressed by the last government, the first answer always was to send for consultants and spend a large amount of money on doing it. Now,
Now, there's no need to get excited. There is no need at all for you to get excited.
I'm getting excited because we're way over time.
No need at all for you to get excited about this. The issues that are being looked at will be published in full. If there's any follow-up action that is required to be taken, that action will be taken.
Thank you.
But there will be. There is no suppression. There is no suppression. And frankly, Deputy Martin, I mean, you know, I can understand why you're on the back foot on planning this week with the debate on the Mahon Tribunal. And you know, it's a classic form of political defence, that attack is the best form of defence. And what you're simply doing here is we're not ignoring it. It is being examined in the Department of the Environment. It will be published in full. Do you understand that? It will be published. It will be done. It will be published. It will be published in full, and then whatever action needs to be taken following that will be taken.
Civil service.